Hey, do you want to know the top social media trends for 2019?
I do.
All right, stay tuned. It's coming up. What's up? John and Nadya Melton here, and we're coming to you live with some important updates. And today we're going to be talking about the hottest social media trends going into 2019. So we've done a lot of research between myself, my team, John. So summed it up.
Due diligence, if you will.
And we're going to bring forward your way the most important ones, right? Like the ones that you definitely want to put into play for you and your business.
Yeah.
Here's what I have to say I'm excited about going into 2019, that social media platforms, like, they actually, if you pay attention, they're very good at showcasing what they want us marketers to focus on.
Yes.
I'll give you an example. When you open up your Facebook app on your phone, you'll notice the very prominent, like, front and center button. It says add to story.
So you know what that means.
So the way that I'm translating that, right, is that Facebook wants us to post more to our stories.
Yes.
Less to our newsfeed. So what's really awesome is you guys are going to notice that social media platforms are going to continue to evolve. They're going to continue to make things easier. And I want you to really pay attention when you open up your app. Like, it should be pretty obvious what they want you to focus on. Like, another good example is when you open it up, right, there's now a button right next to your profile with three faces on it.
Mm-hmm.
And that's for Facebook groups. And now we know Facebook focus is stories, Facebook groups, and of course, live video is always on the rise.
Yeah, so trend one is really identifying the storytelling part of social media, right? Mm-hmm. Like getting some really good stories out there on a daily basis. Now, for some of you, this is going to be a challenge. I get it. But if you can get into the habit of creating content for stories, and here's what I like about stories.
True.
You can actually test things out. Facebook, when they change things, although at first it's like, gosh, that's annoying, marketers ruin everything. And Facebook realizes that people don't want as many ads. They don't want as much promotional content in their newsfeed. And if Facebook is trying to get them to spend more time on social media, then we have to be more strategic.
Right.
So what I'm getting at is with stories, you can test out different conversations.
For sure.
You can test out different things that you would think, maybe I'll post this on my wall, but let me try it on my story first and see if I can create some engagement, see if people are interested in this. Or let's just say you're like, you know, it's one of those days where you're just feeling hot, baby. Like, you got some good stuff to share. And you're
because
like,
you have your vision
but
in
you don't,
place.
But you don't want to cannibalize your previous posts. Like, let's say you posted at 10 a.m. and you're like, oh, I got something really good to say.
And you're fired up.
And it's noon. It's 2 hours later. You're like, but you know the deal. It's like, if I post at noon, it's gonna cannibalize that 10 a.m. post.
Right.
Right? Post it on your story.
Exactly.
Post it in Insta stories and then have it automatically show up on your Facebook stories. And it shows up on your Facebook Messenger story at the same freaking time. Like,
I
think about
it.
That. That's your story genius. Is showing up in three different places.
Mm-hmm.
This is crazy town.
So the conversation that we want to think about is the width versus depth.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So when you think about your posting strategy, when you're creating your marketing materials, right? Like, you got to have the two sides.
Yeah.
Where you're creating content publicly, like for an example, where you would post to your wall, to your newsfeed, like that's a public, you know, post to attract new people, especially if you're using the hashtag, like on Facebook, it's good to use one hashtag. On Instagram, you could do more, right? But then you also got to be building depth.
Yes.
So John, talk about that.
So, and this is something I heard Gary Vaynerchuk talk about a long time ago. He said, social media is a great way, right? You have your public profile.
Yeah.
So you're building width with your audience, meaning you're not even building width with your audience. You're just meeting more people, right? Like, you're posting videos, you're putting out content. The goal is to have people that don't know you that well get to know you more, or people that have never seen you find you because of the content you're putting out there into the marketplace. So it's really expanding your horizon of you know, meeting new people. But the depth is the one-on-one conversations,
and
right?
And the stories.
Yes, replying to comments, sharing stories, right? Putting out value is great, But it's the depth with that relationship that is going to generate leads and generate sales and business, right? So get really comfortable with that width and depth conversation, because it's a great way to really build those solid relationships.
Now, here's a big trend for 2019. It's already been a trend, but it's going to become even more prevalent. And we call this messenger commerce. Ooh. Like, if I could sum it up in two words, it would be messenger commerce. Yeah. So basically, you know, you're not going to show up again with your live videos or with your public content to sell. Like John and I, we don't sell on social media, but we generate a lot of revenue from social media. So I think that little shift in focus, and this is where I want to cycle back to what you were talking about with messenger, right? Really diving into your messenger, building the relationship, making sure that part of your DMO, part of your daily method of operation, is engaging with 3 to 5 people, right? Starting those conversations, it's going to be really huge, and it's going to become even bigger going into 2019, because people want that personal touch.
Yeah.
Like, nobody wants to like be sold. We all love to buy, especially when it's from people that we know, love, and trust, and people that we build that relationship with.
Like, we get this question all the time. Is it better to post on your stories in your wall? And there's not really a yes or no answer. Here's what I'll tell you. I say 1 to 3 times per day maximum on your wall. Look, do whatever works for you. If you're getting results, keep doing what you're doing. But what we've seen just overall, because the algorithm is what it is, and engagement isn't what it used to be, we will see posts in our newsfeed that were from like a day ago, 2 days ago, but we're seeing it for the first time. That tells you that when you post something, the majority of people are not going to see it right away. They kind of spread it out through the newsfeed. So what they're doing is, like I said before, is they want your post to get some you know, traction, and then they kind of see if people are liking it, and they'll determine whether they're going to share it in more newsfeeds. So what I love about stories is you can really test things out, right? You can test out different conversations, so you can post way more often on your stories.
Now I want to talk a little bit about internal marketing. Internal marketing is going to be even bigger in 2019. Like, if I were going to predict some things, right? And it's the same concept of width versus depth.
Yeah.
Like, how many of us spend so much time identifying those new business partners for our business, new customers, right? And once we bring them into our circle, how many of us agree we could do a better job cultivating the existing business that we already hustled so hard to acquire? And the two ideas that we have for you, number one is creating lists on Facebook where you can go and you can create your customer list. So you create a list, which means that when you click on that list, your whole newsfeed is people that are your customers. So now you could bring that strategy forward and be omnipresent with your customers. You can go leave meaningful comments. You could see what they got going on, right? You could do that, like, let's say once a week if you're going to create a strategy around it. But then you can also create, you guys, this is a genius tip right here. You can actually create exact words, exact posts that your happy customers can post onto their newsfeed or into their stories, and then you help them with comments.
You can do this with your leadership as well. Maybe you have personal recruits, you have top leaders on your team. Mm-hmm. You could create lists for that. Potential recruits. I mean, you can create different lists and really zone in on those individuals, because you're like, hey, I want to see their posts first. I want to engage in their stories. I want their stuff in my newsfeed, and I want my stuff in their newsfeed. So not only am I attracting more business, generating more business from social media, but the business I'm generating, I'm keeping it, right?
I'm getting good retention. And you're also optimizing, because it's so much easier to get a referral.
Yeah.
Like all of us, right? We listen to people that we really know for product recommendations, for movie recommendations, whatever it is. So what if in 2019 you made it a part of your strategy to really take a deep dive into your most successful relationships, right?
Yeah.
So these are the customers that are already loving you. They're already loving your products. And you go, hey, like, can you post this onto your wall? Especially if your company has some kind of reward program where they can accumulate points. Yeah. They could, like, get some kind of reward.
Incentivized. Yeah.
For referring other business. And talk about, like, this could be a good strategy of also upgrading some of those customers to now be marketers inside your organization. So here's what's on the rise is live video, right? Consistency in live video is on the rise. So John and I recommend that if you haven't done so already, but I would recommend you start a weekly show.
Yes.
And that's going to be like your signature show. So people know, okay, like Mondays at noon, we do our Money Monday with the Meltons, right? On our business page. So we've been doing that for many, many, many months now.
We've seen a lot of success from a lot of our friends that have weekly shows where you know they're showing up. You know, maybe for some people it's a daily show, right? They show up every day at 9 a.m., right? Like Rachel Hollis, that's how she launched her book. But for most people, we see that that's hard.
Yeah.
Where you say, you know what? I can't show up noon every day. That's too much.
Right.
But I show up every Tuesday at noon.
Right.
Or like we do every Money Monday. At noon Eastern, we do a live broadcast on our business page, and it's consistently, people count on it,
yep.
They look for it. Now, there are times where we're traveling or the schedule doesn't work, so maybe we'll do our Money Monday in the evening, but you can also do what's called a premiere video.
Yeah, so here's what happens. Like, let's say you schedule time and date,
yes.
Right? And you got your show, but for some reason you're traveling, you can't show up, something
yeah.
is going on. So there's solutions now. Now you can feature a public video either as a watch party or for those of us that have business pages. Now there's a thing called Premiere Video.
Yeah.
Premiere Video. Super awesome. And basically it's the same concept, right? But with Premiere Video, you can upload a video, right? And then it premieres at
yeah.
such and such date and time. And because it's a new feature, you guys, here's what you're going to notice, right? When a social media platform launches a new feature, they want people to use it. They want
yeah.
people to jump on it.
That's how they test
it
out.
And when you jump on it right away, and they want to showcase this cool new feature, you're going to get preferential treatment. So I just did our very first premiere video a couple days ago, and it got as high as 100 people were on live watching a video that was already recorded, but it looks like it's happening live right now.
Yeah.
So it's pretty cool, right? Premiere video. So more of an advanced tip for you, but a really good one. Another tip for you is you could do dual broadcasts.
Yeah.
Dual broadcasts. So basically where you go live and then you invite somebody else
yeah.
on. And I want you to think about in 2019, how can you increase your exposure?
Yeah.
Well, a good strategy is to have exposure agents,
mm-hmm.
right? So maybe identify 3 to 5 people that hold the attention of your ideal audience
yeah.
and do some kind of partnerships, right? Maybe you identify a couple of Facebook groups where, again, it's your ideal audience and you bring value to their groups. Maybe you find ways to collaborate,
yeah.
become maybe a moderator to bring content into those communities. Like there's so many different ways for you to now think bigger, because the way that you can grow your following is you can do it by addition or multiplication.
Here's the power in this. When you do it on your personal wall, their audience gets notified at the same time.
Yeah.
So that's kind of cool too, because now there's people that maybe don't know you, have never seen your stuff,
right.
that can now see it. I love dual broadcast because I notice I have a lot of fun and the other person is feeding off of me, I'm feeding off of them, we're bouncing
yeah.
ideas off
yeah.
each other. You could have your customers do dual broadcasts with you.
I love that.
So that you can promote the product, or maybe some of your downline, some of your business partners, you could promote the business to their audience, right? Like, so they could invite you onto their page for a Facebook Live. Now, I will tell you, sometimes it can be a little glitchy. Sometimes you might get echoes, like you can put earbuds in to help with that. Like I noticed sometimes it's, you know, it's just a new feature on Facebook. So sometimes it doesn't work perfectly,
yeah.
but it's definitely something to play with and something I've really liked doing. It's a lot of fun.
I love it. So those are the new trends on the up and rising, up and coming, some things that you should definitely play with, right? Before we wrap it up, a quick announcement, right? Yes. This is going to be a quick promo, but we are doing our 5-day branded challenge. And I'm telling you, it's been completely remodeled. We reorganized it. It's going to be really amazing. I think you're going to love it. So for those of us that go, really, like, what could be that personal brand that I really grow in 2019? Yes. Like, how can I build the community? How can I, like, kind of optimize myself even more effectively on social media? This is going to be the challenge for you. So to get the details, to register, it's free to do. Go to mylifestyleacademy.com/brand. All right, you guys, thanks for tuning in.
We're going to LA.
If you love this video, drop us one of these.
We're going to LA tonight.
Subscribe to the channel, subscribe to the alerts so you don't miss it.